Feeling overwhelmed with deadlines and schedules? Being a student can be tough. In this video, we're going to create a simple student planner using Notion. This planner won't have any complicated features, just enough to keep it simple, practical, and user-friendly. Now, let's begin creating a Notion student planner. Start by opening an empty page in Notion. Click on the three dots in the upper right corner to open the page menu. Here, select small text to make it more minimalist style. Next, give your page a title and choose an icon. Let's implement the functionality of the timetable. Start by using the inline database command to create a database named course. Hide the database title and delete the default property. Rename the property and icons as needed, and create some sample data for this database. Click on the three dots in the top right corner of the table. Go to the Layout tab and select Gallery Layout. Now, let's use the inline database command to create a database, and named it Timetable. Hide the database title and delete the default property. Rename the properties and icons as needed. Add a relation property, and select the course database we created earlier as the relation. In the Limit tab, select one page. Let's go ahead and repeat the previous step for more times. Next, we'll change the column titles to correspond with the days of the week. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. If you want your student planner to include schedules for all 7 days of the week, you can continue adding relation properties for each additional day. Next, add timeframes in the time column. In this example, I'm using hourly, but feel free to adjust as needed. With that, the first module of the planner, timetable, is completed. Moving on, let's create a simple assignment checklist and goals module. Use the two column command to split the screen into two sections. In the left column, type three hash symbols to create a heading 3 style and name this chunk assignments. Press enter and type three minus symbols on the keyboard to get a divider. Now, use either the to-do list command or markdown formatting to create checkboxes. Here, you can list your assignments. Feel free to bold them for better looks. If you want to simplify the use of the student planner, you can use the button command to create a button. Give it a title, click it action, and select insert block. Choose above button and create a checkbox and divider inside it. This way, you'll have a shortcut button to create new assignments anytime you need. Now, let's move to the right column. Use three hash symbols to create a heading 3 style, and name this chunk goals. Use the callout command to create a view like a box. Choose a Notion icon or upload your own icon to represent it. If you want, you can also click on the six dots on the left to change colors. With these steps, you've created two handy modules for your student planner. Now, let's delve into one of the most crucial aspects of the Notion student planner, the task management. This functionality allows you to compile a comprehensive list of your tasks and removing them from your list once completed. To implement this feature, start by creating a new database named Tasks using the inline database command. Hide the database title and delete any default property. Change the title and icon of the attribute. Next, create a checkbox property within this database. Rename the column title to Completion and create two button properties within the database. One labeled Completed and the other Redo. Next, click on the completed button property, then click Edit Property, configured to mark the associated task as completed by checking the checkbox. Next, click on the Redo button property, then Edit Property. Once again, edit for the completion checkbox and set it to unchecked. Once we've completed, let's try out the functionality of these two buttons. Once we've ensured everything is working smoothly, click on the three dots in the top right corner of the table. Go to the Layout tab and select List Layout. Then, go back, enter the Properties tab, and display the completed button. Name this view To Do and change the icon. To get a more minimalist style, we prefer not to have the paper icon next to the tasks. Click on the three dots in the upper right corner, navigate to the Layout tab, and toggle off the Show Page icon option. Then, input some sample data into the database. Next, duplicate this view and name it Completed and change the icon. Click on the three dots in the top right corner of the completed view, enter the Properties tab, hide Completed button, and display the Redo button. In the To-Do view, click on the filter, add Completion as the filter, and select Unchecked, while in the completed view, select Checked. With that, we've completed this Notion Student Planner. In this video, we covered the usage of Notion databases, relation, checkbox, button property, markdown syntax, and basic Notion commands. This is just a basic Notion Student Planner. If you need a more comprehensive system to manage your student life, you can also refer to my previous videos. In that video, we used Notion to automate note scheduling, exam, and group, or individual assignment management. I hope you found this video helpful. If you can't wait to start planning your student life right away, feel free to download the free template in the description below. Thank you, and stay organized.